One topic that came up on the appearance of Donald Trump, Laura Ingraham, was the attack on the Capitol in January. Here's what Trump had to say about that.
It was a zero threat. Right from the start, it was zero threat. Look.
Okay, so zero threat. He goes on to talk in. You remember the day of the weird things he had to say about how he loved them and they were very special? He talked in the interview with Laura Ingraham about how the rioters were hugging and kissing Capitol police officers. He said, hugging and kissing.
Some of them went in and they're hugging and kissing the police and the guards. You know, they had great relationships. A lot of people were waved in and then they walked out. Direct
quote. That's a good Mulaney.
Former. Yeah. They walked in with their high feminine hips. And then they walked right out. Like that is.
Yes, there were some rioters who felt very comfortable with the cops. And then there were also rioters who tried to beat the cops to death, who tried to crush them indoors. We saw video of them with a flag trying to beat a cop to death. That is not a hug. That is not a kiss. It is very different. So 2 months out, facing a continued investigation about how he might have incited that violence, and the Republican Party trying to be very careful afterward, distance themselves, and imply that it wasn't them at all. I mean, remember, like half of Republicans believe that the people who were hugging and kissing cops were Antifa. Trump is still speaking very favorably about them, even though the audience watching that show thinks that they were lefties that were doing this. That is the takeaway. And so as we've been saying since like January 7th, man, I can't wait to see what people are gonna think about that attack in a year. What the lingering beliefs about that are going to be. We already know, just a couple months out, how solidified the insane misinformation is on the right when it comes to that attack.
Yeah, and they don't care. They don't care about reality. They haven't figured out, man. And they're just gonna go about it, their business. Until the next go around, or until someone forces them to, and they did for a second, like Newsmax and OAN with Trump on social media. Then, like that's very key here. Is Trump is not on social media to send people to OAN and Newsmax when they don't take Trump's call. Now they're back in a position of power where the only way that Trump can talk to that group who hasn't quite figured out where OAN is. Is to call into Laura Ingraham.
Yeah, exactly.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.